Hi guys, how are you doing? Nice having you here again. And for this video, I actually have some drawing for again. Is that how you say it? For again? No, that is not correct, but that's how I'm gonna say it. But yeah, I have some drawing and I have some studio footage, and I also have some updates on the next store opening. So, and also gross stories about gross things happening these last couple of weeks. So let's start with the little studio footage, look how things are going over there, and then we'll move on to the proper speedpaint footage with updates and stories and stuff. Alright? Yeah, sounds good. So let's into... I really can't speak today, so let's see how this video goes, but yeah. What? That's my phone telling me to wake up. I already woke up, so it's fine. Well, this is a great intro, but yeah, let's just move on. Welcome back to the mighty, mighty mess in the studio. The shelves from Ikea arrived, though. By the way, it is Sunday, the 26th of July, I think, and these arrived on Friday. And I have a bunch more over there in the corner. It's the Ivar shelf set, the same that I have over here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use some wood stain to paint these. The wood stain that I lost. Where is my wood stain? Oh well, it's somewhere. I'll find it. One set of shelving mahognified. Step two is putting this together. Ta-da! One is done. Now let's make a second one and put some things in it, or on it. Alright, it is almost midnight. I've been working for a good few hours. I'm really slow at putting this together, but I have two shelves, two Ivar shelves that I've made look not so yellow. And I'll have to continue some other day. Here's the carnage and the reason why I really needed to protect everything. But yeah, I have like two more shelves left to do. And but this was really good. I already have... let's look at this. I'm gonna have space to store all of the packing materials on the sides here, so that I don't have my... so that I can fit my feet under the packing table. And... motorcycle in the middle of the night. Other people awake too. And this area is so perfect because it fits perfectly for packaged books, this one shelf. And I'm gonna have to put in like more shelving, of course. I only have like one made for each. I have a bunch there that need to be prepared with the wood stain. I think each shelf carries 36 kilos is the safety limit, so this many books about, a few more, and then I will put like another shelf, and you know, for each 36 books set. And then I need a shelf over here. Oh my goodness, so much garbage. And of this going to the recycling, and these are some pre-packaged single book envelopes for the next opening, and there's a bunch of all of the paper that comes out of the boxes that the books are in, and I'm gonna reuse them as filling when I need. And these are all of the boxes I still have to open. I was gonna do it today, but I'm getting kind of tired. I need to still finish a few panels of next week's comic pages this evening, and so I need to go home. But only this many books left. The pile is looking mighty big. But it's nice, I'm getting everything in order so that I can actually tell how much space I need for everything, and yeah. So that's the report for today. Eventually, once all of the shelves are in order, I can clean everything up and put everything in their own places. Like right now, I still have like the label printer on the floor and everything. But yeah, going good so far. So an update on when I'm gonna do my next little store opening. This week, actually, or the week that follows me uploading this video. I think I'm gonna be uploading on a Sunday, so yeah, the week after this upload is when I'm gonna reopen. By the way, if you want to kind of be up to date on that at any time, I have a newsletter on my website of my comic that you can sign up to, and I will post stuff like that there first. Both like Kickstarter news or store updates, and it's also where I post like when the comic comebacks from breaks and stuff. So if you're worried about missing it, that's where you will get the first notice. But the countries that I'm gonna be opening to next is the Nordics, the Baltics, Germany, Poland, and the Benelux countries. So basically the countries that are surrounding the Baltic Sea, pretty much, or very adjacent to it. It's the ones that are easiest to ship to, I assume, and will have the least problems. So yeah, those are that is the countries that are on the list next. And yeah, it's gonna be someday next week when I feel like I am mentally ready for a 200 or 300 more orders, or however many it will be. But yeah, that's the update on that. Nothing else to say. I guess I could mention that it seems like my publisher is getting pretty close to launching a Kickstarter for the international launch of my book, or book 3 of the comic. So that's gonna be available, hopefully, maybe within the month even, for everyone everywhere in the world. They don't have any shipping limits, I don't think. They ship to anywhere. So yay for that, and I will of course post the news on that when I actually have a date. But yeah, that's all for store updates. What else should we talk about? I promised I would tell you guys the gross happenings of my week, or the last couple of weeks. I have had to throw away a lot of things because of these annoyances. So the first thing that happened was I dropped a gigantic bottle of sweet and sour sauce, the kind of really goopy orange kind. I dropped it directly on like the edge of my big fluffy white carpet or rug in my living room. I know, carrying sweet and sour sauce in the living room, very smart. So I dropped it right on the edge on it, so that it, like, all of the sauce went on the carpet, but it also hit the floor, so it basically exploded the whole bottle, and it flew everywhere. Of course, the first thing I did was grab Kitty and put her in the bathroom behind locks, because there was glass all over the place, and she was of course directly running over to start licking the sauce. And then I had to put shoes on and walk around trying to find all of the pieces of glass, all the gooey goop all over the walls. Like, literally 4 different walls had goops of sweet and sour sauce. I had it on some curtains, the rug. I honestly had decided to throw it away in the end. It is a pain to clean. It's way too big for me, and it's too heavy for me to properly carry around. It's like really dense and rigid, and it's round. And every time something happens and I have to clean it in the shower, it is such a pain. It takes hours to do,
it doesn't even fit in my shower, so it's kind of curled up along the walls while trying to do it, and it is just kind of a gross rug at this point, because, you know, it's the place where Kitty likes to go and puke. Sometimes she wipes her butt on it, and sometimes I spill sweet and sour sauce and blueberries and stuff, and I have always managed to get, you know, stains out after much work, but this time I decided it's time to give up, and I just cut it up because it's too big to carry to the trash. So I cut it into two pieces and just rolled it up, and off it went. And now I don't have a big rug in my living room anymore. I have a smaller one now. But that's a good tip for anyone who lives alone. Don't get a rug that's too big for you to clean easily on your own. You will eventually be left with a disgusting rug that is just in the way. But yeah, that was the first gross thing. I had to clean a bunch of goop, orange goop and glass from everywhere. I even found a shard of glass in my bed. Like, honestly, it just exploded like a grenade, the thing. But yeah, that was a couple weeks ago, or a little over 1 week ago. And then, about a week later, Kitty got massive diarrhea in the middle of the night, and I did not wake up to the sound. She was also puking. She must have eaten something really bad. And I woke up, and there was a pool of puke and diarrhea in different parts of the house. Kitty was happy and doing great. Like, I had noticed the day before that she had been kind of tired and not eating well, so I had actually been like keeping an eye on her and being prepared to go to the vet the next day. But no, she woke up really happy, walking around, wanting to go outside, bright-eyed, everything. And the reason was that she had gotten out whatever was bad with her tummy. And unfortunately, during the night, she had also stepped in it, specifically the brown diarrhea pool. And after I had, you know, cleaned up the pools, I started noticing paw marks all over the place. And I had to track where she had walked until she had, like, washed herself. And it was first on the floors, but then she had also jumped up on the one of the sofas or the chair and a table. And, like, I had to throw away every fabric thing she had stepped on, because I'm not gonna start washing those. It's too gross to keep. So I had to wash or throw away the covers on one of the sofa. Thankfully, I have, like, you know, stain covers on everything, because I am well aware this is something that happens when you have a pet. So I had to throw away one of the covers. My kitchen mittens, you know, the things that you use to take out things from the oven, she had stepped on those. And the rug was already out. I mean, at this point, if I hadn't thrown it away, I'm sure it had already would have gotten a second splash. Had to wash a bunch of tables. I had to throw away the pillow covering, someone's pillow. And I had to wash her favorite blankie. That one I could not throw away. She loves it too much. But yeah, that was the second gross thing. Diarrhea explosion from Kitty. She has been really good after that, though. So thankfully she's not sick. But then the final thing happened. A few days after that, just a few days ago. This one is the grossest one, I think. I have actually... how do I start this story? I buy my cat food online from, you know, an online animal store, and it comes in a big cardboard crate. And I ordered something a couple weeks ago, like a big box of it, and I have a cupboard where I put all of it away. And this time there was like a couple of boxes of cat food that didn't fit in my cupboard. So I kind of left the cardboard box that they all came in the hallway by the outer door, just kind of waiting for there to be more room as she would eat for a couple of weeks, she being Kitty. And yeah, I just left it there to wait until I have some space to put it away. And I did not think about it anymore after that. And this last week, I started getting these little wafts of smell in different parts of my apartment. Usually when I bent down to pick something up, I would smell something like near the floor suddenly, and it would be gone like really quick the moment I tried to smell where it comes from. And first I couldn't tell what the smell was. I was like, man, is it my trash or something that I need to take out? And I would just take out the trash every day because I thought it was that. And I was like cleaning the drain, because like maybe there's something in a drain that smells, or maybe something in my refrigerator is going bad. And now I just try to clean all kinds of different things. And eventually I realized what the smell was. I recognized it as the smell of rotting flesh. And that is not a great smell to have. And I started thinking that Kitty must have caught like a mouse or something and brought it in and hidden it under the furniture. So I went around moving all of my furniture and stuff, trying to find a rotting mouse or something. Because still the smell was like, I could not smell it when I was like trying to find it, and it would just linger for a moment in like a corner or a spot where the draft carried it around. So I could just never tell where it's coming from, and every time I would smell it, I would just be like, oh, it's right here somewhere, move everything and try to find something. But no, I never found it. And then this last week, a few days ago, I bent down next to the cardboard box to clean something, and I smelled the smell directly there. It was so strong, and I lifted up the things inside the cardboard box, you know, the little inside boxes with the cat food, and one of them, oh, it was broken, or something inside the cat food box was broken. Like, I would never have thought about that, because I have never had an issue with, you know, a factory sealed cat food container being broken right when I buy it and, you know, leaking. And yeah, it was so disgusting. I immediately grabbed the thing and went outside and put it out, because you know, when I moved the box, basically all of the smell kind of just got out of there. I guess one of the reasons why the smell hadn't like reached me properly was because most of it was like being contained in that cardboard box in the corner on the floor. So, you know, the smell was just kind of there. And when I opened it and moved it around, it was like just floated all over the everywhere. And the box itself, it's like it had maggots on it already. Ah, so gross. And the moment I put it out, like flies started swarming over it all over the place, because it was such a strong smell. And yeah, that was so disgusting. I ended up just keeping all of the doors and windows open and cleaned the whole floor under the cardboard box, just in case anything had gotten out. And now I have learned that I have to check all of my cat food boxes when they come and check that something isn't leaking inside them. And honestly, if I had put the thing into the cupboard, right, with all of the other cat foods, I would have smelled it earlier. Because, you know, when I open a cupboard, I can smell if there's something wrong. And it kind of, any smell would be like concentrated in there during the night and stuff, you know. But because it wasn't, it was like one box that I couldn't put in there. It just got to sit there for almost 2 weeks, rotting in the warm summer warmth indoors. And it's like, it's that kind of cat food that's like 80% meat. So it's literally just rotting meat. Oh, so disgusting. But yeah, that's my story for gross things this week. I guess a quick kitty update would be a good way to end things though. Kitty has been very cute, and she has killed two shrews. One of the reasons why I really thought she had hidden a dead animal somewhere, because she has been very actively hunting. And yeah, two middle of the nights I have been greeted with a critter. But the thing is, she always announces when she catches something. Like, she's so excited about it. I always know that she has something on the way because I start hearing this kind of sound. Because she's like screaming on the top of her lungs, but she always has her mouth full of whatever she's carrying, and she's like running in with it. And yeah, that's the kitty update. She's been doing good, other than her one vomit and diarrhea explosion day. And that's honestly everything I have for this week. It's I've just been working on drawing the comic for as normal as I should when it's ongoing and not on a break. But next video I will probably have a lot of packing and stuff again, if I do open this door, which I should. And maybe I will have updates on the Kickstarter for the international launch of the book. We'll see, I don't know. But thanks for watching this one. I hope you enjoyed the drawing, which I never even mentioned. It's just a painting in watercolors in my sketchbook of Lolly sitting among some random what are they called? Ferns? Do they look like ferns? They're supposed to be ferns. But yeah, and also, if you somehow happen to be new here, read my comic. It's free online. And yeah, that's all. Bye bye.